We are here today in the south end of the boardwalk that runs on the west coast of Barbados between basically a whole town and Sunset Crest. And we're at the southernmost point of the boardwalk. This is the one of the entrances where we came in, the entrance to the beach from the main beach road just south of a whole town, about a 5-10 minute walk. And basically I brought you here today to show you one of the nice little other points well worthwhile to visit while you're here in the west coast by St. James. And we are now, I turned over and we're facing the north side, the boardwalk that this runs about a kilometer north and ends in the actual town of Whole Town. But the purpose of this video here today is actually to show you a little bit the beach, which is known as Beachlands, which is just across from a new condominium development that's going to be built in the next couple of years. But more importantly, there is a lovely new beach right in the front here, which we are going towards, which is what I call the Beachlands Beach, which for the lack of a better name is what is how it's referred to at the moment. And as you will see, it's a small beach, but very cozy and very quaint, very comfortable, and quite popular now. And it's only about a 5, 10 minute, 7 minute walk to our condominium that we rent here, which is just a short walk up the road past the at the entrance of the beach road. And basically this is the beach that, as you will be able to see, there's a number of catamarans and other tour boats out there, and this is the beach that these boats make a stop for purposes of the snorkeling. And as you will see, there's a lovely coral reef just at the southern end of this small beach, and it's full of fish and the occasional turtle as well. And roughly 11 o'clock every morning, these catamaran tours come by and dock. And as you'll be able to see, there's a bunch of people out there. There's also a sunken reef, a sunken boat down there that's become a reef, and they take people down there. There's a lot of some big fish down there as well, but you can actually reach the reef and the sunken boat straight from the beach. And that's what a lot of people do now that are familiar with the area. Everybody brings their equipment, and basically you just swim out from the beach straight out into the snorkel area. So very entertaining, lots of very colorful, surprisingly number of fish down there. And you can also here at the beach, you can get some other, you can get some boats off of here. You can rent some of the skidoos if you like to skidoo as well. And one of the reasons this beach is actually quite popular now is because it's been recently, they've done some recent works in the beach to try to preserve the sand here. And you will see that they've built some groins out there. It's these rock formations. And there's basically two sets stretching across the front of the beach. And it's designed to cut back on the waves and prevent sand erosion, which otherwise takes place at different times of the year. So you'll see here that they actually still have the sign for the coastal works, the works that was being done. And I'll see if I can focus in a little bit for those of you that might be interested. It basically is discussing the construction works being in three parts, and there's two protective offshore breakwaters, and they remove two of the existing northern groins, and then they dredge the sand from the seabed to re-nourish, rebuild and extend the existing beach. So quite extensive. It took about a year to get this done, and they've done an excellent job. And at one time when you used to come in here, there was very few people that even came here. Now it's become one of the more popular hidden jewels here of the beaches in the south coast, on the west coast. We are actually, this is the beach immediately north of the Sandy Lane Beach, so, and immediately south of the Whole Town Beach. And as you will see, very popular. And one of the other things that you will find here when you come is that there is also a large sign here that tells you about the work that's being done with respect to the turtles. And basically indicates that in the Beachlands they have a variety of palms, flowering trees and so on, and Barbados mahogany is here as well. And they've, even while they've been doing it, this is going to be the site of the new Beachlands condominiums, right in immediately behind us. And basically properties here will be, most of them I suspect have been sold already, but probably anywhere in the range of $1.5 million to $3 million. So if you're, if that suits your budget, you can certainly buy one of the properties right here and step out of your condo right into the beach, which is very nice. The other side here, as I was referring to on the with the turtles, is that they also have here an element about the turtles, and there's a variety of turtles that can be found here in Barbados. The green turtle, which is pictured, there's also a leatherback and a hawksbill. And the hawksbill turtle nests predominantly in the south and west beaches of Barbados, which is this area. And towards the end, towards November, you sometimes see the little turtles hatching and coming to sea. And they, Barbados is very protective of their turtles here. And an adult female will nest every 2 to 4 years. And, you know, they usually return back to the places where they were born, and they will deposit up to 150 eggs. The size of ping pong balls into nest cavity in the sand. And occasionally when you walk around, you can actually see some of the little sand nests that the turtles have nested on. And they ask here people not to handle the eggs and to help protect them. So this is a beautiful living reef set off the southern end here. And of course, teeming with sea life, including starfish, colorful tropical fish, and turtles occasionally, as I mentioned. I'll take a little walk down the end here to the other side of the beach, where you can actually get a lovely view also of hotel, it's about a, if you want to take a walk, you can actually walk the southern end of this beach all the way down for a few miles. The main thing to do, however, is to make sure that you walk on low tide, because on high tide there are certain areas that are simply impassable. You can't get through. But otherwise, as you can see, it's a lovely spot. The boats are out there today, so we're just past 11 o'clock this morning, maybe 11:30. Certainly worthwhile a stop when you come to visit Barbados. I highly recommend as well taking these boats if you haven't before. It includes lunch, all the drinks you can have, and certainly they take your boat snorkeling in the reef as well as swimming with the turtles. So all in all, a wonderful time, great place, great location to hang out and get some sun, meet some people, meet your fellow travelers and even some of the locals, and highly recommend it. I will put this on pause momentarily, and then we'll take a little view from the south end as well. Well, we are back again here now in the south end of the Beachlands property, and as you'll be able to see, I'm pointing southwards towards the right on the tip there, where some of those chairs and some people are laying down, is the old Almond Beach Club. Now under new ownership, it's called The Club. And immediately past that turn on the far end, you'll be able to see that's the hotel, Sandy Lane Beach. That Sandy Lane, for those who are golf aficionados, enthusiasts, will remember, is where Tiger Woods and his ex-wife, of course, came and got married and had their honeymoon here. It's a lovely beach down the end there. And of course, as I mentioned, although right now you can see there's water surrounding that tip, on low tide you can actually walk around and make your way to the beach. And beyond that, the beach beyond Sandy Lane down the far end there, if you look and a little bit further there, and I'm going to zoom in a little bit more if I can that way, that's actually called Thames Bay. That's also the stop where the boats stop and often go snorkeling with the turtles. So all of it is about a 15-minute walk, hugging the terrain right around. And as you can see, there's even somebody here this morning trying to do a little bit of surfing, which will be an interesting... hey, it looks like they're going to be all right. You can see there's also some people swimming right in front of a protected area there by the beach hotel, the club. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make a little wide turn, come back to the area where we just came, and you will see here that what we have here is we're back in front towards where the all the snorkeling people are doing their thing. I will myself make my way out there shortly, and because it's a lovely time of the day. I'm sure it's not too wavy here today, so it'll be wonderful, very crystal clear waters, beautiful fish out there. And as I point my way back here as well, you can see that on the far side down the end there is where I started the video, and the entrance to the beach from the public entrance to the beach from the main road. And now I will just head my way, we'll make our way back to the main area of the beach where I am. And you'll see here, this is the sales office for the Beachlands property. And of course, some of the beach vendors around, there's not too many of them, and most of them, if not all of them, are very polite, and you really don't get hassled here in the beach very much. And it's really a joy and delight to be out here, and highly recommend anybody on the West Coast to come out here and spend time and meet people and just basically enjoy, you know, everything that Barbados has to offer. So on that note, I will put an end to this video today. I will post it on YouTube for those of you who hopefully are interested and will get a chance to appreciate. And my apologies for the shakiness of my hand with the video, but otherwise, definitely a worthwhile exercise and highly recommended. And look forward to seeing you all here in the future, and all the best to everybody. Bye for now.